understand.
I've heard about you. You've got some.
It doesn't matter, you know. Yeah. Anyways, okay. I just want to ask you something. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you consider yourself a hadith ejector?
No, no. Like I've been saying to the guys.
Yes, I want to know your position. Okay, yeah, fine. First.
I do not. I am not a hadith rejector.
Right.
I'm not a sunnah rejector. As long as those hadiths and those practices or the sunnah
are in agreement with the Quran.
Correct.
You see, I'm finishing your statement. Do you know why? Your statement is rendered useless. Can I tell you why?
Okay.
If I say I only accept a hadith if it's in a, if it's in agreement with the Quran, I don't need the hadith because the Quran is there.
Okay.
So any hadith that agrees with the Quran is not really helpful in any way, shape, or form. If the Quran is already there, I don't
need it. It is, but
I'll tell you how that statement is useless. To say that I accept the hadith that is agreement with the Quran is useless for me, right? It's another way, it's a twisted way of saying I reject hadith, right? Do you accept a hadith?
No, but can I go to that point before you change your point?
No, it's the same point. It's the same point.
I want to address this.
Let me finish the question. It's the same point. I'm saying, do you accept a hadith which are not in agreement or disagreement with the Quran? Do you see this point? Do you accept a hadith?
Yeah.
No worry, I'll repeat again.
Yep.
Do you accept a hadith which are not agreement or in disagreement with the Quran?
So it's just been added?
No, not been added. Right. It's neutral, right?
You have certain neutral position.
You have certain statements of the Prophet,
right,
that does not necessarily contradict, right? Or in line with the Quranic verses, right? You have a hadith like that.
Yeah.
Do you accept that type of a hadith or not, right?
Okay.
Or do you only accept, as you said, the ones that are in agreement with the Quran? Now you can.
Okay, so going back to your original point, like I said, I don't want to.
It's the same point.
Skip
yeah.
what you said.
Yeah, that's fine.
Where you're saying, it's where if my statement is rendered useless. Where if there are hadith that I don't need, that is not saying the same thing as the Quran.
No, I'm saying if the
that's
hadith.
That's useless. As in, wait a second,
do you understand my point? I'm
yes,
saying if the hadith.
Because you carried on, I kept listening to you and I forgot your original point.
I repeat it for you.
Right.
I'm saying if the hadith
yeah.
is saying the same thing as the Quran.
Right.
Then I don't need the hadith because the Quran is there already telling
okay,
me the
let's
point.
Pause there. Right. Let's pause there.
Okay,
right.
Yeah.
So let's say this brother is a Christian.
Okay.
Or he's no religion. He's an atheist and he has no idea. Then he reads something. One day he opens a book and then it's a Quran. And to him it's nothing. It's just a book. He doesn't believe. He doesn't believe in God.
That's fine.
And he reads something in the Baqarah. It talks about the cow when Moses came down from the mountain. And the people of the Bani Israel, they said, we need proof that you are from Allah. Show us what kind of cow it is. And he had to explain the cow.
He didn't say, show us proof that you are from Allah.
They needed proof. That's the only way they sacrifice.
They didn't ask for proof.
I think
you're talking about the verse without understanding the verse.
What I'm trying to say.
Do you remember the verse?
Let me just kind of give you the context. Then I will come back
But before you make claims about the Quran, you need to
yes.
be accurate, you know?
Yes.
If you're claiming the Quran, I've said something, you have to be accurate
yes.
there. I'm telling you the Quran doesn't say what you said. Musa said to his people.
In Baqarah.
I'm talking about Baqarah.
Yes. No, I'm not sure.
I'll give you the beginning now. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً. When Moses told these people, I'll give you the context. I'll give you everything. Don't worry.
No, but
when
Moses, going back to the point.
No, because
I need to make this point.
Okay.
Brother.
So retract the other statement,
the
and then we can
was,
move on.
Right. The point was, if there was a hadith or if there was a teaching that tries to teach this brother. Sorry, I'm not using it as an example. I'm just trying to explain something. If that hadith explains this verse to this brother and that makes that brother closer to the Sirat al-Mustaqim, what's wrong with that hadith? There is nothing wrong. In fact, it is light and guidance. And actually, what Allah says in the Quran, do righteous deeds. Righteousness. What is righteousness? It's making someone, helping them go on to Sirat al-Mustaqim.
But you're not getting my point, my brother.
No, but you're saying it's useless. It's not useless.
You're not getting the point. I'm saying your statement is useless, not the hadith is useless. I'm saying if you say the hadith is already telling me the same thing the Quran is telling me, why do I need the hadith if the Quran is already there?
If it explains.
I'll give you an example.
Right, if it explains.
If the Quran is saying in chapter 112,
yeah.
say Allah is uniquely one. And I have a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ when he said Allah Azza wa Jalla is one. He doesn't have another, for example. He doesn't have a second. For example, that hadith to me, I don't need it because the Quran is there already. So when you say to me, I accept hadith that are in line with the Quran,
yeah.
in essence, you're saying I don't accept hadith, I only accept the Quran because they are in line with the Quran. That's my criteria.
No, you've misunderstood. The reason why I'm saying I reject some hadith is because men are infallible. Men are fallible.
Okay.
We write things with our own hands.
Was the Prophet fallible?
Sorry?
Was the Prophet fallible?
No, he's Rasulullah.
So he's not fallible?
He is not fallible.
Okay.
The Rasul is not fallible. So, and hold on. The reason why we have to be cautious of things that we read is because A, because of politics, and B, because of the greed of men, we don't know. None of us here
can
know.
Can I understand your argument?
Where? Go on.
Your argument is, I reject some hadith because men are fallible, correct? Am I representing you correctly?
Part of what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's not exactly
Am I representing you correctly?
Yeah.
Right?
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Why do you accept the Quran? Men are fallible.
Why do I?
Why do you accept the Quran?
You need to stop laughing. Okay. This is, we're talking about Allah. Just, you cannot.
Don't be worried. Don't be worried about what people are doing. Okay. Be worried about yourself, right? Right. I'm not laughing, am I? No, I'm just asking you a question.
Right.
If hadith, as you said, you reject some of it because men are fallible.
Yeah.
I'm now holding you to your own criteria. Be consistent. Yeah. Why do you not reject a part of the Quran?
Why do I not reject the Quran?
No, a part of the Quran, because men are fallible. Maybe there is a mistake there as well.
No, because this is divine revelation.
How do you know that?
Allah tells us.
How do you know Allah told you? This men that brought you the scripture are the only reason you think Allah told you anything.
Because nothing has been added into the Quran.
How do you know?
I have faith.
You have faith?
Yes.
So now you're saying
I have faith in the words of Allah.
Ah. So now you have blind faith.
No, it's not Quran. Blind. It's not blind.
So here's the evidence.
Okay, so there's the evidence. Please. Apart from the Quran, where else does it say believe only in God and what God has revealed? It says it in the Torah. It says it in Zabur.
How is that related to what we're saying?
Because
the talking about preservation of the Quran now. You said to me you believe in the preservation of the Quran.
If you believe,
can you give me evidences for you as yourself? What's your name?
Yeah, Dawan.
Dawan?
Dawan.
So Dawan, I'm asking you for evidence now, holding you to your criteria. Men al-Falibun, men brought the Quran to us. You have never met the Prophet in your life, neither have I, right? So the men that brought you the Quran are also the men who brought you the hadith. If they are fallible and they will make a mistake in the hadith, they can be fallible and make a mistake in the Quran.
Right.
So now this is a consistent argument, consistent criteria. Now please enlighten me, on what basis do you accept that the Quran is preserved?
Okay, so you made an assumption, which is an assumption only.
Tell me which assumption.
It is not a fact, where you're saying the same men that brought us the hadith are the same men that
who brought the Quran. Who brought you
Robert,
the Quran?
Let me finish, because I was respectful.
Because you're talking about the assumption. Go ahead.
Yes, you made an assumption.
I'm disagreeing.
It's only an assumption.
Okay.
Because back then, we're talking 1400 years ago.
Okay.
There were no computers. There was no point of fact evidence. The only thing we have is the most plausible route, right? If it's the most plausible, that's it.
Which is what?
Which is narration. As it was passed down from generation to generation.
Do you accept narration now?
Well, that's the only thing. There is nothing else.
Okay.
Unless there's an alien who decided to have a...
Can you tell me one chain of Quranic transmission?
Chain? What do you mean?
That narration you're talking about, it's called a chain of transmission, yeah?
Right.
Where you have men in the chain narrating from one another to us, yeah? Okay. Now, you don't know any chain of narration. I know that. Leave now. Please don't use terms you don't understand. Please.
No, I don't understand.
I know.
I'm trying to
know.
See if that's...
I understand, but I'm not talking about mutawatir. I'm telling you right now, there's a transmission and there is a chain. There is a men in the chain, correct? You do not know a single chain of narration of the Quranic revelation, right?
Right.
These narrations, the men in the narration, are the same men who are transmitting the hadith. So it's not an assumption. It is a fact that the same people who brought to you the Quran are the same people who brought to you the hadith. Now, repeating my question again, on what basis do you accept the Quran, even though it's coming from the same source, and you reject a part of the hadith claiming that men are fallible, but not applying your consistent criteria with the Quran? I'll tell you something, I'll be nice with you. Look. The end of hadith rejection is Quran rejection. That's how things work. No one can be in his right mind.
Somebody else mentioned this as well.
No. Let me respond. I'm giving you evidence now.
You're making multiple points. And when I'm thinking about the
point,
you're making
one point.
No. You're making multiple things that
which
I
ones?
Want to agree with. But you keep changing your point. And I want to address them.
The one
but
point.
But you keep changing. And I'm respectful. I let you talk.
Address only one point, which is I'm dealing with, which is...
Right.
That the people who brought you the Quran, the same people who brought you the hadith, you're rejecting based on the men. It's the same point we've been discussing for a while now. No other point.
Okay, I'll go back to what I said. It is an assumption you are making.
I gave you evidence.
Not just you, but our forefathers. The religion of our forefathers tells us.
No assumptions.
That the narrations that you're saying, for example, I have no knowledge of the science of hadith. It's true. Why? Because what's important, Allah says, I have not left anything out of the Quran.
Where did Allah say that?
When it's a complete book. This is a complete book.
No, you said Allah said, I have not left anything except the Quran.
No, outside of it. As in nothing.
I have not left anything outside the Quran.
You can't quote me word for word.
No, bro, if you say Allah said.
You can't quote me word for word. Because I'm not here.
I'll tell you something.
I don't have a report. I don't have a report.
Bro, I'll tell you something important now. You're getting angry because I'm quoting you word for word, right? Yeah. Imagine you quoting Allah Azza wa Jal wrongly. How would Allah be okay with that? Now, if you're quoting Allah Azza wa Jal,
I have with the same standard. If I try to explain something to this brother,
no, but
in
my brother,
way so he understands,
my brother, this is the second time.
Word for word.
This is the second time I correct you regarding Quranic verses. The first was about Musa. You made a wrong claim about what happened there.
It's not wrong at all. No. The people, when Musa was on the mountain, the people asked him for evidence to show that Allah was actually in that they wanted to know the cow. You know, when they were asking for what type of cow this is. Is this incorrect?
They did ask what type of cow it is.
Right.
But you didn't say that. Go back. It's on camera. But look. I'll tell you the thing about camera. People cannot run away and escape their points. Yeah. You made
what
the point.
What do you think I said?
You will see on camera what you said.
No,
you
said, I said the same thing.
Can I repeat?
I'm trying to repeat? Yeah.
Okay. You said that they were asking Musa when he came from the mountain, Musa alayhi salam. You said they were asking him for evidence, right? They were not asking him for any evidence. The story goes as Musa alayhi salam is the one who's telling his people. Musa alayhi salam, in the beginning of the scripture, he goes, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرًا. Allah is saying, when Musa said to his people, Allah commands you to slaughter a cow.
Yes.
Then they said, are
make
you
it
taking
clear to us. Yes. Yes.
So there was no evidence he's coming down, they're asking for evidence. It was Musa alayhi salam giving them a command,
right.
And then they were inquisitive and inquiring what type of cow it is. Now,
right.
So that's the first mistake you did. Second mistake
but
is
why is that important? As it's
important because it's the Quran.
No, bro,
I want to quote
message.
It properly.
You're,
it's not the same message.
You're stepping above, but it's the same message.
No, it's not.
It's not incorrect. What I said
it is
incorrect.
It is because
they wanted to be sure.
No, my brother.
Like the people needed to be sure.
Brother, let's not go around yourself. You said he came from the mountain. They were asking him for evidence. That's how you're saying the story goes. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying it didn't go this way. Therefore, it's a mistake. I'm saying if you quote Allah, if you quote the Quran, which you claim that to hold on to, at least quote it properly. That's the only thing I'm asking you to do.
Yeah, but the way
if you don't
saying,
know, if you don't know, open the Quran
what you're saying,
and read.
The way you're saying
read, read from
the
Quran.
Way you're saying it is if I said something completely different. If this is blue and I said it's red.
You did.
This is not red.
You did.
I did not say this is red.
You did say something different.
No. It's the
you
same
did.
Thing.
No.
They wanted to be sure, make it clear to us what kind of cow it is.
If I come to
so
you.
Then he started to make clear. Now, why?
Okay, before, no, you made a claim. Let me just.
You're not letting me speak, and I'm trying to make it clear to you.
I am letting you speak.
I sat down. I stood respectfully listening to you, and I was trying to think about
you're
the points you were making.
You're speaking as well. You're speaking. You're not silent.
If Allah brings down a book through a messenger, through a rasul, this book is for humanity. Why? To bring us out of darkness. As in, I'm not. Don't quote me word for word. Think about it. Use your reason, as Allah instructs in the book. Use your reason. Use your intellect. If we are in darkness about something, Allah sends this book to bring us out of darkness.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
That's in the Quran. I agree with it.
Good.
Yeah.
Now, why is the Quran not enough? Not just the Quran, but we've got, for example, Zabur, we've got the Injil and the Torah. Why is that not enough?
Okay. Now, the answer...
Apart from the fact that it might have been changed, because some other brother said, because it says those who...
No. I'll tell you something.
Hands,
I'll tell you something.
To them, but
something about people who reject Hadith, right? They try to play around the point, right? I will easily 100% answer your question, which you're saying, why is it not enough? When you answer the question that you avoided, on what basis of your criteria do you reject some hadith claiming that men are infallible or fallible, sorry, and you accept the Quran even though it's also by men, even if it's not the same men, because you're holding on to that point. I'll give you that point. Let's not say it's the same men. Let's say it's also coming from men. Our men are fallible. That's your criteria. On what basis do you accept something which came from fallible men and you reject something else on the same basis that it's coming from fallible men?
Okay.
Then I will answer your question gladly.
Again, I think you're misquoting or you've misunderstood me. What I'm trying to say is, if a certain hadith, or if I'm explaining something, so a hadith is an explanation, right? It's trying to teach us wisdom, hikmah, as some of the other brothers were trying to allude to. It's something that is trying to teach us something apparently that we didn't know already, right? So, if I am trying to teach somebody who is not learned, somebody who does not know the way, and I have learned it from the Quran, and I'm teaching that person in a form of a hadith what I have learned from the Quran, that is a pure hadith. That is because I'm not doing anything different. I'm not doing word for word, but it's like teaching physics first time to a year 7 who has no idea what physics is. You are introducing them to it. But the ultimate aim is for them to be on the right path.
Okay.
Therefore, that is not bad. But when you start doing things that have nothing to do with the Sirat al-Mustaqim, what's the point? Like, you go back to you, there's no point.
Okay.
Yeah.
You haven't answered my question. So, again, so not asking you to go around the point. You've told me that, the hadith is an explanation of the wisdom, something that elaborates on the Quran. It's not related to what I asked. My question was, on what basis you accept something? Oh, look, I'm making it clear. This is the fourth time. I know you don't have an answer. We can move on if you say,
no,
I don't have an answer.
You're choosing not to listen. You're choosing
so what
not
is the answer you're giving
me?
Yeah, tell me. On what basis do you accept the Quran is preserved? Even though it's coming from men which are fallible.
So, okay, the question you're asking me, how do I know the Quran is definitely preserved?
No, I'm saying you reject the hadith.
No, but based, you just said, on what basis do I...
Just let me finish the statement, right?
Yeah.
You said you reject the hadith based that men are fallible.
Yes.
That was your reasoning, right?
Men are fallible.
I said to you, be consistent. You have to also reject the Quran or a part of the Quran, like you reject a part of the hadith, because men are fallible and men brought it to you. Now, again, asking the question, on what basis do you reject one and accept the other? That's my question.
When, okay, Quran
no answer,
as
right?
divine, no, there is an answer.
Tell me.
You're rushing.
I'm not rushing.
Okay,
I'm
because
waiting.
What you're saying is,
I give have me the answer.
What you're saying is, I have to choose one or the other or not choose any of them.
Yes.
When originally,
I am saying that actually.
Originally,
yes. I am saying that, yes.
Originally, there should be no choice. Originally, it says
that's
in the
your
Quran,
opinion.
There is only divine revelation. That is the only.
Where does it say that?
No, what I'm trying to teach you, sir. The Quran teaches.
Teach me, where does it say in the Quran? Where does it say in the Quran?
Well, when it says only
there is only divine revelation. No, you said the Quran says there is only divine revelation. Where does it say that?
The Quran teaches divine revelation. When it talks about the
Quran,
when it talks about the.
Again, I told you, quote the Quran properly, yeah? Because I'm not going
to
let you just misquote the Quran,
yeah? Everybody put these cameras on. Nobody asked my permission to be recorded.
You say, I
don't know why.
You were happy speaking with the other brothers. I don't know what happened now.
I've
but
been
look,
talking
look.
For 2 hours, that's and fine. I'm being labeled with things that I'm not.
Okay.
For example, I am not a hadith rejector.
Did I ask you in the beginning? Did I ask you, are you, or did I label you?
No, you did ask.
Okay, so let's not talk about other people. Let's talk about what I did. You have
as
a conversation with me. Okay, let's come back.
Labels that.
Sure, let's come back to my discussion. Clearly, you don't have an answer, so I'll make it easy for you. I'll let it go. I'll let this point go. Now let me ask a question now.
Rabbi, I answered that. You're not choosing.
I'll let the viewers decide. Okay, now let me ask this question now.
Right.
Do you believe there is any revelation? Because there is, you said the Quran is the only revelation. That's what you just said. Do you believe?
No, I said there's four revelation which Quran talks.
No, leave the other books. I'm not talking about the other books.
Why are you leaving?
I'll tell you. I'll explain to you. Because we're discussing hadith now. We're not talking about the previous scriptures. I'm saying, do you believe the Prophet Muhammad? Leave now the other prophets, yeah? Do you believe the Prophet Muhammad received any other revelation other than the Quran? Or do you believe, as you said to me, the hadith was an explanation that the Prophet ﷺ was given? He looked at the hadith, right? And he was explaining the hadith as he thought his wisdom, right? Do you believe there was revelation on the Prophet ﷺ other than the Quran? We believe, yeah?
At the same time as the Quran was being revealed. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
I just want to understand.
Ahl al-Sunnah believe that there is two types of revelation. One is the Quran and one is the Hadith. That's what we believe. I'm asking you right now, do you believe there is other revelation other than the Quran?
At that time, no.
So you believe there was no
at
other
that
revelation?
Time, the only divine
at that time, I'm asking at that time.
So we're not talking about before the Prophet.
The time of the Prophet, yes.
The only thing that was revealed to the Prophet was the Quran.
And
through the angel Gabriel.
Okay. Was there any other revelation revealed on the Prophet until he died or only the Quran?
As far as I'm aware, I've read the Quran four times. I read it very regularly.
Doesn't look like it, but yeah.
I read it very regularly.
Okay.
You can make derogatory comments. This
no,
is
it's
fine.
The truth. That's what I'm seeing.
We've got a laughter in the background.
It's what I'm seeing from you, but go ahead.
No, I don't believe that there is other than the Quran.
Okay.
There is the wisdom.
Okay.
But the wisdom is only taught by Allah. This is gifted by Allah, just the way it was gifted to the Prophet.
Okay.
When
so
it was gifted, it was gifted by Allah. Men cannot.
But it's not a revelation.
Sorry?
It's not a revelation
no,
you have to follow it.
Of the verses.
Okay, so it's the Prophet understanding.
Right.
Okay, now you just digged yourself a hole, I'll tell you.
No, you see.
I'll tell you why.
Statements.
Let me tell you why.
Brother, these statements, you cannot make these statements because
I can. I just did.
No.
But let me just tell you why.
The argument in a way it's not meant to be.
You can tell me, oh, it's not a hole after I show you the hole, right? Okay, now let's talk about the hole. Now you said to me.
I didn't realize we were in a circus. I really didn't.
Okay, sure.
I thought this was a discussion about Allah.
How many times have I laughed since our conversation?
It's not about you, it's about the people.
Okay,
that
then you're concerned
you.
About other people,
because
man.
I don't know
these people, man.
I am a
I never
hired.
Met them in my life.
You are with the cameras. Like,
no, I never met these people in my life. You met them the first time. You met me the first time.
I'm not the one with all the.
Okay,
know.
Let's just come back to the hole. Let's just come back to the hole. Let's come back to the hole.
Let's go back to your hole.
Okay, let's go back to the hole. Now, the Quran says that Allah Azza wa Jal commanded the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, right? There was a previous command to the people to direct themselves to Masjid al-Aqsa in the Quran. Now that command does not exist in the Quran.
Okay.
Yeah? There's a previous command before Allah tells now turn your face into Mecca. There was a previous command to face al-Masjid al-Aqsa. That previous command does not exist in the Quran. So my question to you, did the Prophet alayhi salam made it up? Did the Prophet tell the people, you know what? Guys, you should face al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And then, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells them, no, change to Mecca. Or was there another revelation?
There is a verse that says, Allah says, if you turn your faces to the east and the west, Allah...
I'll give you the reference. I don't like to go around. I'll give you the exact reference of what I'm talking about. Chapter 2 of the Quran. starting from 100, 142. I'll just give you now the context, and let's see. You have your Quran with you or no?
My phone, yeah.
Yeah, get your Quran. Maybe you have your Qurani Quran, isn't it? Okay.
What chapter, verse?
Surah Baqarah, verse 142. Starting from 142. Let's read what the Quran says. Because you read it four times, so we can see. I don't know. You missed
Raman,
this
one. This is not fair.
Just.
You need to be on a level playing field with me. You
sure.
Know? You can't raise yourself above by making.
I'm not raising myself.
Silly
above.
Comments.
I'm not raising
okay,
myself.
Okay, dig a hole and stuff.
Can,
it's not about hole.
Can
it's
we
about
read
facts?
Can we
get facts?
I'm telling you, 143. Let's talk about the facts now. Read 143.
143.
Read it.
Right.
He's taking it personally, that's why.
And so we made you a moderate nation, that you may be witness over humanity, and that the messenger may be a witness over you. And we only establish the direction of prayer, which you once followed, that we may distinguish those who follow the messenger from those who turn on their heels.
Can I stop here?
Right.
We once made, Allah is saying, He made a previous direction to a qibla. He made it. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الْقِبْلَةَ الَّتِي كُنْتَ عَلَيْهَا Allah made a previous direction of prayer. Now,
you
in the next
Quds,
verse,
right? You said Quds before.
Sorry,
you talked about. Quds.
We believe
but
from our hadith. It's not in there.
Okay,
we believe from the hadith. We don't take
right.
The Quran alone.
Right.
I didn't say the Quran mentions al Quds. I said
right.
The Quran mentions the previous qibla. So
okay.
Let's deal with that
again,
point.
It's an assumption.
No. Let's deal with the point.
That.
Let's deal with the point now.
Right.
So can you answer me? Where is that previous command of the qibla in the Quran? By the way, that's the first question I'm asking you. There's many other questions. But that's the first question.
Well, God is telling you. When are you saying where is the command that God says turn towards the qibla?
No, it's the next verse. I'm saying the first qibla, which is this. That Allah said we have made the first qibla as a test.
Right.
Where is the command of the first qibla? In the Quran. In the only revelation, sorry, let me repeat it. In the only revelation, where is the right. Command, the previous command of the qibla?
I have not found it yet. I'm not saying I know everything. You're speaking as if I know
Alhamdulillah,
everything.
I know right. The full Quran and it's not there. Now, if your claiming is there, my brother, if your claiming is there,
you're saying,
can bring it.
You're saying the previous Qibla was Quds.
Leave Quds now.
But you made this point. You know what? I retract
the point.
Right.
I retract the point. You
right.
Claiming I say Quds, I'm retracting the point. Now, let's deal with the point. Let's not run away because I know you like to run away. Now, please tell me which is the previous Qibla.
You love these comments.
Where is the previous Qibla? Where is the previous Qibla?
Mentioned, yeah.
Where is the previous Qibla mentioned in the Quran?
Yeah, Allah said we commanded you before to follow a Qibla
right.
In the past.
Okay.
Allah, we said we made a previous command. That command is not the Quran. So
right.
Where did that command come from? Did the Prophet make it up? What is Allah talking about here then?
There is another wahi.
Or there is another revelation.
Yeah.
Again, I can't say that I know.
No, we're not done, by the way. We're not
okay,
done.
All right.
Okay. It's the first question, yeah? It's the first question.
But where does it say to find this information, go to a hadith or go to a sunnah or go somewhere else? Where does it say that?
I didn't say that.
Okay, so you are making an assumption. We've already talked about this, bro. You're like 2 hours late.
Don't digress to him. Speak to me.
Yeah, I know, but I've got
I'm
this
saying,
whole,
I'm
yeah?
saying to you right now, I'm not concerned with what they say.